I'm Dwayne Carl, and I'm from Redondo Beach, California. And the church, to me, is the biggest way to we can eradicate stigma. That I really do believe that, because so many people go to church and worship. But I always grew up in a religion that in our churches that preach against homosexuality, and it says that homosexuality is a sin, which I don't believe in that. I am an AIDS survivor. I want to make that clear. 18 cells, viral load over 200,000, and 7 opportunistic infections that was riddling my body back in 2002. So I was literally on my deathbed. I always had problems with issues with my church, you know, churches, period. You know, because I was an out gay man and proud to be out and gay. Actually, two things happened. One, I was at a church and I was up for minister of music. And I submitted a resume, and this church was my church home. So I went in to speak to the pastor and let him know. I wanted to be open and upfront with him about it, because I understand what the church's position was about homosexuality. And but I could have led the choir and been a great choir director. And he looked at me and he said, "Well, you're wonderful and we love you, but because of you being an openly gay man, you could not be minister of music for my church." I decided I didn't want to be a part of that. And so it was great, because it was actually a sense of relief for me on that. And I spent my time then devoted to just having a spiritual relationship and connection with God, and having meditation practices that I do. Gay men who are in the church and who want position of leadership, in order to feel that they have to get that, they will marry a woman and unfortunately then have relations with men outside of that relationship. And sometimes they slip up and have unprotected sex, causing them to be HIV. They're not going to go back to their wife and use a condom. Okay, now she's HIV. And believe me, I go to some of these churches and speak, and I have so many of these stories from black women. I found out that the National Black Presbyterian Caucus in California was having a huge event celebrating their 40 years of service to the community, all right? So I sent them an ad to put in their program books, and I was like terrified, but okay. And it's actually this cross, because now as an AIDS survivor, I had this tattoo put on my body, and it says "Pause Boy" in the middle. And it says, "Only God can judge me," you know. And so I put that in this ad commemorating their wonderful service. And so I didn't think I was gonna get the heat, but they called me and had a conference call with all their 5 of their board members and said, and they did deny, and actually I thought they were gonna deny putting the ad in, but they didn't. But they asked me several questions about my interpretation, and because it was the cross, they felt that this was desecrating the cross because it was at the center. I said, "But this reminds me of all the persecution that I received over being gay and having AIDS, and I hope you want to understand that. Well, we need you to redo your, we need you to put that in there, so because folks are gonna be calling us and this, that, and the other." So they started to tailor the conversation a little bit more about homosexuality and AIDS, and I said, "Sir," I said, "in all due respect," I said, "if Jesus was here right now, walking this earth, would he ostracize gays, lesbians, HIV, people with HIV and AIDS? Would he discriminate, and would he condemn any of these people to what you call hell?" And the whole place was, you could tell that no one in the conference call was dead silent. You could hear a pin drop. And the next thing you know, you hear them say, "Okay, well, sir, I think we got what we need." And so thank you. Just, if you could just make those changes and resubmit it, and then the ad will go out and we'll let you know so you can have a copy and we'll send it to you, that type of thing. They need to be able to read the book and come to the conclusions that it's not about what their personal beliefs are, but it's more about now a human condition. We have to do this so that we can help save lives. Out of my second closet, I have AIDS. Get over it.